Welcome back to the channel, everybody. Started off with a little fire, and we'll get to that in just a second. But first of all, I have to thank all of you that showed up to the Guggen Squad HQ meetup over the weekend. The biggest turnout we've ever had for a meetup. And it wasn't just a meetup, it was really an all-day hangout for us and really just celebrating opening the HQ and the store. So, thank you for coming. We enjoyed getting to hang out with you, and there's going to be a lot more to come from that place, as you can imagine. So, I'll link the Guggen Squad channel down below. A lot of new videos coming out of that place. And the store is officially opening for business now. That was our big grand opening, but you can head up to the store at most time, regular store hours, and we have it staffed and ready for you. Second thing. New merch is available. Eat, sleep, dangle, y'all. I can't tell you how many times I heard the word dangle at the meetup. Of course, it's a big part of this channel. We dangle all the time. So now we got merch available. Eat, sleep, dangle. I'll be doing a few more of these as well, so look out for them. It's going to be linked down below, so go get you some dangle merch. If you've paid attention to this channel for any period of time, you probably noticed when I go fishing, I almost always wear a belt knife, and it's usually this one right here. This is my my Mora sheath. I use a stainless steel knife while I'm out there. It doesn't rust, and I just keep it sharp. I keep it ready. I find it really efficient for tying knots. It's, of course, easy to cut braid, clipping my knots close, clipping the knots off close to the eyelet. And how many times you've been out on the water and you get tangled in fishing line with a crankbait, or your hook gets caught on a rope on the dock, and boom, you got your knife ready, just clip it right out, and you're good to go. Big shout out to Brandon. He's a man of God. He is also a man that knows how to make sheaths. I got a lot of respect for people that do quality work with their hands. A lot of you reach out to me that do woodwork, do metal work. Just all sorts of like crafting, welding. This was especially awesome. Brandon contacted me and said, man, I've been watching all your videos. I see that you've got, a knife, a belt knife all the time. I make custom special knife sheaths, and you gotta get rid of the one you got and let me make you some. So here is what Brandon made me. Now this, everybody, is a knife sheath. Not just a knife sheath, but also a plier sheath combo. And it has been with me since April on just about every single fishing trip that I've been on. You've probably seen it in some of the videos with me when I caught my 10 pounder, when I've been crappie fishing, a ton of trips, and I've been using it, but I haven't talked about it until now. Brandon's company is called Red Rhino Customs, and he makes sheaths for just about any kind of knife, mostly hunting and fishing knives, but this is the first one that he's done as a plier combo. So I was honored to be his first outdoorsman to get one of these. The great thing about these is they are the Kydex material, which is, you commonly see that in gun holsters. It's a really light but rigid material. It allows you to clip whatever in there, mold it to it, and then it's not gonna come out. You gotta just put pressure on it to pull it, and then when you push it back in, that click, that's what locks it in. You know it's in there, and it's not gonna pop out of the sheath. So really durable. Thing that I was concerned about was the weight, like putting pliers and a knife on the same unit. So what he did here, he created a small little piggyback for this set of pliers, and I got a set of pliers that they're kind of pricey, but I thought they would just be perfect, and they are for this. This is like a pair of trout to small fish. Like it's perfect for bass and things like that. If I was getting in the catfish, stripers, it might be a little too small, but these are made by a company called Cheeky, They ran about $100 actually. They were kind of expensive, but they come on this this little doodler here, and you put them right in there, and Brandon molded that so that those specific pliers would fit right in there. And Brandon just does a really good job on the craftsmanship of these. I don't know how many people make these kinds of sheaths, but he takes extreme detail. I've talked to him on the phone probably 5 or 6 times about each individual sheath, and he got it perfect. So he didn't stop until he got exactly everything that I wanted. And man, I just kind of let him turn loose with this one because this is the first one he's ever made. And I said, hey, this is kind of what I want, but you do your thing. And he did. The other thing that's really nice, it comes with a premium leather dangler. This is actually called a dangler. I'm not even making that up. I heard that. I was like, wow, perfect. Yeah, the dangler. And then it's got this nice big metal ring here. So when I'm out on the water, I usually am wearing like longer pants. I wear the belt, put it on there, and it's just right there on the side. Wah bam. Now let me just get y'all in here on this quality craftsmanship. Wah bam. I don't know how long these things will last, but they look like they'll be with me for a long time unless I lose them. See that? See how that Kydex works right there? Just locks in. God, y'all, it feels perfect. It is light years better than those other sheaths. Now, this is the one I use the most, obviously, because I fish a lot, but there's some other hunting ones and camping ones that he made too. I want to show you those inside. Let's go. Now that we're here in the fish cave, we can take a closer gander at these combos. So each knife has a purpose, you know, and these sheaths also have a purpose. So really the only three that I could ever imagine me needing are a camping one, a fishing one, and then a hunting one slash just kind of like a general outdoor use sheath. And the camping one is awesome. I love the way all these came out. Mostly black, it has green on the top. And this is inside of here is my Mora Black. I really like Scandi grind knives for camping and sometimes hunting. They're just really easy to sharpen while you're out there. For me anyway, just the way that the Scandinavian grind is, you can just look at it and see the line you need to sharpen on easier. Over here, I've got a flashlight that holds right in to the side of the Kydex. So that's custom done there. And this flashlight is, it's literally just a $20 flashlight. It's made by Olight. It's their 3T. Just takes one AAA battery. And I like this one because you can clip it onto your hat as well. Wah-bam. And then you're good. I actually use this in New Zealand. Then on the other side, we have our Faresium rod. And it's got like carbon fiber look to it on the accessories and the back. Like it's a two-tone, looks good. And all you do with that, you pull it out, you take the flat side of your knife, and then you run it across there and sparks will come out, and that helps you to start a fire. Also, a pouch on top of here. So you can pull this out. This is like a canister where you can keep, you know, tinder in there, you can keep first aid, you can keep an extra battery for the flashlight. I've got some matches, some cotton, a little fire strike, and some like little bandages, first aid stuff. Even put my LFG logo right on there. I thought that was really awesome. So that's called the Mega Pouch, and that goes right onto the knife. So that whole package just sits there, and you can take that off if you want to. The hunting sheath, or just the general outdoor sheath. This is a piggyback combo as well. I've got this taken off right now. This was the knife I used in New Zealand. But the main knife sheath itself, it's got a really cool camo pattern on there. I can't remember the actual name of that pattern, but he showed it to me. I just thought that was really cool. This is my SE6. It's a 6-inch knife, and it also has a little bit of orange inside of the grip there, so it matches perfectly with that. This is like a, you know, general purpose all around knife. You can, you know, use it to chop wood, branches, beat it up. It's actually light enough where I like to use it just for small tasks too. And then there's a sharpener built into the side. This is a Gatco
scepter. It has a little sharpener system here that you run the knife through. I would never use that on a knife. Don't do that. That takes a lot of metal off your knife. But what it is awesome for making sparks, is there's another frisium rod right there, or ferrule rod. I can't remember what the name is. You take that and you run that through that sharpener, big sparks come out of it. So you have a diamond plated sharpener right there that you could sharpen your blade with. That screws into there. It's just a, you know, all-in-one system. A lot of weight though. A lot of weight you're gonna carry around with this thing. And then it piggybacks onto here with another Olight flashlight mount. That actually goes on the side of this right here. I just kind of outrigged this for, you know, hunting, like skinning animals. This is a SE Azula 2, which is a good little skinning knife. It's super lightweight. I took the handle off of it and wrapped it in paracord. So you could take that off and use it, but I actually like the feel of the paracord and it fits in there perfectly. The way he molds these so that they sit in those grooves is just perfect. He gets it right. Those are my three amazing knife sheaths now. And I also have a rack that's on the wall for all my other knives and everything. And I'm probably gonna reach out to Brandon at Red Rhino for some more in the future, maybe for like a fillet knife or something like that, because I love them so much. They're almost like collectibles too. Like, these are literally things that I'll pass on to my kids. If y'all want to get your hands on one of these sheaths, obviously you can't just pick them up. They're custom made. They take a little bit of time, but Brandon walks you through everything, make sure that you're gonna get it right. I would highly recommend, if you're a fisherman, going with one of these combos right here. It'd make a really cool special gift to somebody too. And you don't have to get the like real expensive plier like I did. I just wanted to go as light as possible. There's a lot of other cheaper plier options that you could do. And he'll custom make it around that. So that's what's really cool. His business, Red Rhino Custom, is linked down below if you want to go check out the Instagram page or the website and just kind of browse around and kind of get an idea. And it also helps him spend more time at his church. This is a side business. Church comes first, but he's a pastor over there. So, alrighty, that's all we got for today. Thank you for hanging with me here in the Fish Cave and talking about some kniflery. And if y'all want to check out the links down below for the new Dangle merch, I just kind of went around in circles there. Let's keep it PG. Obviously, go check out the cool sheets over at Red Rhino Customs. And if you want to check out new Guggen HQ, I'll have it linked down below as well. We have a brag board set up in there right now, so if you've caught some mondos on some Guggen baits, make the board. We've already got some 8s, 9s. I don't think we have a full 10 yet. There's one that's close up there. But if you come into the store, you might see myself or Rob or any of the other guys in there occasionally, and just hang out. You know, put your picture up on the brag board, take a selfie with Gary, do whatever. We made this for you and for us to go create content up there. So thank y'all for tuning in today. I love you. Make sure to subscribe right here to the channel so you don't miss a single dangle. And I'll see you on the next one.